Almost.
Almost drowned.
Almost drowned twice.
But lucky I'm still alive.
The first time?
The first time was when I'm 9 years old.
I was
9 years old, and then the second one when I.
Cerita, cerita panjang sikit. The first time.
First time
was when I was.
I was almost drowned when I was 9 years old.
Cerita lah, it happened because cerita macam mana dia yang hampir berlaku.
I can't swim.
Okay.
I managed to learn to swim, but I really can't swim.
Cerita why it happened. Explain it to you.
Okay. For the first experience when I'm inside the.
No, yang hampir lemas tu, ceritakan lah. Yang pertama tu, cerita lagi.
He taught me
semua past tense.
He taught me to swim. But I really can't swim until I'm drowned.
Okay, the second time.
The second time
happened when?
Happened at the beach.
Which beach?
Tanjung Aru Beach.
Okay, Tanjung Aru Beach. When I was 14 years old.
Yes, 14 years old.
It happened because
I tried to swim, but I really can't swim.
Okay?
So, from this experience, I really learned fear factor. Managed to swim.
To overcome my fear
and try to swim using a
snorkel.
And my buddy, my instructor, teach me how to swim in the right way.
Okay, good.
And then the second one is.
The second reason it was unforgettable. Okay. It was unforgettable.
The second reason.
It was unforgettable.
Unforgettable moment.
Because.
Because
Pandang kita, pandang.
Diving. We learn to breathe without using our only mouth, not our nose. So what happened is we have to focus inside the water. We have to breathing in the right way only using our mouth, not nose. Okay?
If you forget,
then you will almost drown.
Okay.
So the instructor will teach you how to breathe in the right way, how to focus, how to make yourself very confident with him. And then the third reason, unforgettable moment when you have to trust your body, means your instructor that you didn't know him at all. But you have to trust him because he will bring you inside the water till I think 20 meters deep. Yes, deep inside. Whatever happened inside the water, inside the sea, you have to trust your body. That's it.
Do you have any question?
Is it hard to blow the water once
you enter
your goggles?
Masking clearing is the one of very hard for me because you have to focus. You have to mask clearing. You have to put inside the water inside your eyes. Then you have to push like that. Then breathe out using your nose. Then you have to open your mask clearing. Then you have to swim. Then you have to.
I don't understand. Sorry.
Okay. When you have to do a mask clearing,
You need
to
take off your goggle.
The second one is take off your goggle. The first one you have to take the water inside your mask. Then you have to push the water from your nose. Then the second one, you have to open your goggle.
Goggle.
Then you swim. then you have to put it back. Again, you have to push the.
Do what? This is doing what?
Press the water to keluarkan air daripada ni. Mask clear.
To clear the water.
To clear the water from your
mask.
Yes.
Okay.
I think that was the hard.
The most difficult.
The most difficult. The other is to focus only breathing using your mouth.
Pertanyaan ni ada jumpa jepun tak? Pertanyaan ni ada jumpa jepun tak? Ada jumpa jerung tak?
Did you see shark?
Did you see any shark? Before this? While you are diving?
While I'm diving, I didn't see a shark. I didn't see any shark, but I managed to see a green turtle.
That's the only thing you saw. Only a green turtle.
So many fish, but I cannot recognize. I don't remember their names.
Okay.
But very good experience for us. If we got opportunity, we should try. Very good.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay.